Yeah, this is all going on YouTube. I like to put my all these games up on YouTube. Scrubkiller joining before I can get four players into the lobby. What a muppet. Oh, nice. We've got X3 joining as well. So we'll get some threes games. Or threes? Twos games. Scrub and Turbo. Scrub and Turbo definitely wanting more 1v1s. We might have some time for that later. They can settle their differences between themselves. Oh, I thought we'd switch it up a little bit here. How viable did I think the Roadhog is? It's pretty viable. Let me just update the screen, the overlay real quick, or the title, I should say. So we got the correct information. And we'll get into Scrub and X3 versus Turbo and Yemen. Of course, X3 and Yemen used to be teammates together on the old SK Gaming, really the first team to try kind of challenge Flipside's dominance in the pro scene, back when Flipside were winning absolutely everything. They kind of came in with a style which was very aerial heavy, very quick in the air, just very focused on hard clears and long shots and just a barrage of pressure, which kind of countered Flipside's style back then, because Flipside weren't so familiar with getting up in the air quick. Even Cux, who was well known for his aerials back then, was not doing the fast aerial. I'm not sure if he is yet. But yeah. This is the kind of thing you'd see if you saw the old SK with Yemen and X3, and also Jazer was in that team. You just Yemen deliberately hitting the sideboard right there so that Turbo can come in for the rebound. And Turbo does so really, really well. Thoughts on Genocop joining Retrospect? I'm really glad to see Genocop back in the scene. It was a real shame when he left momentarily. Speaking of people who left the scene momentarily, X3MW is kind of one of those players. After his stint on SK Gaming, which fell apart when the team broke up, Yemen booting Scrub at the goal. Oh, and a nice finish. Turbo, again, just looking so dominant. But yeah, X3 kind of left the scene for a bit. I don't know where he went, but he seems to be back, and he seems to be playing Rocket League a fair bit, so it'll be nice to see him back in action, see if he can get back up to his original level of play. He was one of the best players in Europe at a time, and indeed the world. Is the half flip jumping going backwards and flipping backwards while boosting? No. The half flip is, well, usually it's most commonly utilized to get your car from driving backwards to driving forwards in the opposite direction. And you do that by, the first thing you do is you backflip, and then just about when your car is like, when you're backflipping your car, when it gets to about here, you throw your analog stick forward and left, or forward and right, just diagonal forward, and hold your air roll key. And what will happen is your car will, it'll start the backflip, then like the rest of the backflip will continue, and the diagonal front air roll will counteract that, and it'll kind of roll your car like that, and you'll just land on your wheels facing the opposite direction. So that's a backflip followed by a diagonal forward air roll, about just a bit before halfway through your flip. Turbo dunking on Yemen and accidentally putting the ball towards his own net, but doesn't go on target, and he would have probably made it back in time to keep it out regardless. Yeah, Ryuk and JJJ Squad is a great Keeper Demise player as well. I was always in the Genocop, like the Genocop club as regards the best Keeper Demise player. I think he's probably the best. Of course, Ryuk, keyboard only player. One day Ryuk from originally Three Musketeers and now JJJ Squad alongside Jazer and Krazak. Good old Ryuk sat down at his PC and thought that I'm just far too tired to play Rocket League from here, so he went to his bed, stretched the keyboard out all the way over to the bed, and the mouse wouldn't reach, so he just rebound the mouse keys to the keyboard and said, "Yep, this will do," and never looked back. Played full keyboard Rocket League ever since then. I believe he uses jump, boost, air roll, and camera look back on UI, J, and K respectively, which is ridiculous. One of those ridiculous things I've ever heard of. But meanwhile, it looks like Turbo and Yemen have just settled into holding onto this lead. X3 and Scrub not able to put up much pressure of their own. Hopefully, for their sake, they're able to do something. But Turbo has had a pretty good record against Scrub, looking to make it 4-0 today. Scrub definitely not happy with himself. It's worth mentioning, perhaps, that Scrub was live streaming these games, which can be a little bit distracting. I've streamed a lot of my own gameplay in the past, and I always used to find that 1v1 in particular was very difficult to do on stream because it just, I don't know, demands so much focus and attention. You're kind of splitting your attention between live stream, chat and with the 1v1 itself. So, but that being said, it did seem that Turbo had a pretty good read on Scrub's attack. He wasn't giving in many goals, and Scrub was getting pretty frustrated at that, taking bigger and bigger risks, and eventually Turbo would score counterattack goals. Also, Turbo's demos were very on point, and Scrub's were not. So, Turbo was able to take down Scrub in ones, and now if you add Yemen and X3 into the picture, two players who do play very similar styles of Rocket League are Yemen and X3, except both of them whiffing the ball simultaneously. That's not the style I'd anticipate. Regardless, Turbo's still able to get the better of Scrub. Good game. Hopefully we can get a couple more, because I want to see best of threes, and rotated lineups, of course, are always good to see. I mean, for the most part, that game we saw a really good assist from Yemen for the first goal, just deliberately missing the net to set up Turbo. And then for the second goal, we just saw Turbo with a shot into a pretty undefended goal. So well done by Turbo both times to get the finish, and Yemen again, credit to him for the first goal. Deliberately missing the target because, well, the reason behind that is just putting it in a difficult position for Scrub, who was goaltending at the time. You don't want to put the ball anywhere near the goaltender. And Scrub, nice dribble, probably doing all that with ball cam on because he's incredibly stubborn in that regard. And of course, Scrub, if you can't beat him, join him. Just gets right into Turbo's team this time. He's going to try and get a first win of the day, at least in these lobbies. I don't know if he's won games outside. He doesn't go for the pass, kind of using Turbo as bait, but X3 is not having any of it. Turbo uncharacteristically missing the target. That one would not have been a deliberate miss because Scrub was not in position to follow up. It was just a, you know, straight miss. Oh, good pass from Turbo. Scrub with the redirects and targets. Yemen actually using his own post to defend that one. So well done. Oh, Turbo, beautiful dribble. Really good shot. X3 noteworthy, not putting himself in a position to follow up on Yemen's challenge. Like, when Yemen goes for this challenge here, X3 wants to put himself in a position that he can follow up, and he kind of just turned away. I've got a feeling that he was about to challenge, then Yemen cut in front of him, and X3 changed his mind but turned away from the ball. It might not be the best plan. Turbo maybe gonna go for a floor pinch? No, goes for the early hit. Floor pinch probably wouldn't have worked because X3 was very close. Great touch and feel by X3, beautiful goal by X3MW. The first touch here is really what made this possible. You know, you got the great 50-50, but then this touch here, that's just a gorgeous first touch by X3. Really, really good touch. Johnny, I have a problem. I get this bug report in Rocket League. Decided to delete Rocket League on PS4. Now you can't download it back. You downloaded the first version before Season 2. Any advice? I have no idea, my friend. I'm sorry, but I cannot help you with that. I never played Rocket League on PS4, and I'm afraid even if I did, I would not be the person to ask. But I hope you fix that. Be sure to, I don't know, tweet at Psyonix or even at one of the devs. I'm sure somebody will be able to help you out there. Or even email customer support, I guess. Yemen actually missing the ball, but Turbo had respect for Yemen's hit, so he backed off. Turbo did steal the boost, though. Yemen completely boostless on the wall. But X3 is able to deal with it regardless. Scrub somehow reversing. I don't know how he ended up backwards in the wall right there, but he does control the ball. Will he go for the infield pass? Yes, he will. And it's just, it's as simple as that. This is like why infield passing is so good. Look how easy this is. Look how easy this is for the attackers to do, and look how hard it is for Yemen to deal with. Because he doesn't know, he's got no idea where that ball is going to go. And of course, Yemen with the classic Yemen excuse, had lag on that whiff from earlier. I don't believe him. I don't believe him. Quality sportsmanship from Yemen, as per usual. Of course, another player who's known for his low levels of sportsmanship is Turbo Pulsa, but he's not had to showcase any of that today because he's won every game, so We'll see if he loses a game and starts to rage in the chat. I don't know. Some of these players need to learn manners. They need to learn how to be humble in defeat and gracious in victory. What's some customer support? I have no idea. Scrub with a good goal. Nice rebound. He doesn't need turbo help for this one. You know, controlling the ball off the wall, getting a great. It was kind of a, you know, aided pinch because that kind of hit both him and X3 on the way to the net. Of course, Turbo gonna show up in chat and complain now about me slandering his reputation as being a little bit of a rager. I mean, we've all had our moments where we get frustrated in Rocket League. Competitive nature gets the better of us. But we don't need to let competitive nature get the better of us. We can rise above this and just you know, say good game, well played, regardless of the win or the loss. But I mean, it's looking like Turbo's going to collect another win here. Yemen and X3 have been under pressure a lot this game. Oh, Scrub going for a little bit of mind games of his own. He does get T-boned off the boost. Yemen stealing that one from him. Scrub recovery to put the shot on the net, but it wasn't a very powerful one at that. I mean, speaking of, you know, bad sportsmanship, there's a lot of young guys in the Rocket League scene, and, you know, it's easy to just, you know, get mad when you lose. X3 capitalizing on Turbo's misplay here, getting a second goal of the game. You know, a reasonable first touch in field, but Turbo should be dealing with that. He just gets in an awkward position on the wall and backflips past the ball. So not the greatest play by Turbo. X3 bringing Yemen and himself back within one goal. We'll see if they can get another to equalize. Nice jump by Yemen, but maybe psyching out X3 a little bit as he came in his approach right there. No way, it's actually on target at X3 with his third goal of the game. Turbo wasn't ready for this calculated shot by X3MW. Look at this, this bounces off Scrub Gila's car straight into the net. Beautiful. Oh my goodness. You're too hard on him. You kind of like Yemen. Yemen's a, you know, he's an all right guy in chat, if albeit a little bit attention seekery. But as far as competitive gaming goes, he's got a lot to learn in the ways of just not getting really mad when he loses. He's a great player, but you're not going to go far in a competitive gaming scene if you know, can't keep your cool when you're losing. So actually, an equalizer. After I called it, is looking pretty comfortable for Scrub and Turbo. They concede two goals in quick succession, one from a misplay by Turbo and another by a really random bounce, which Turbo did not respect. And Scrub actually taking himself out of the game there, something I'm not a fan of. And another thing I'm not a fan of is that, you know, atrocious air dribble by Yemen, but it's actually going to result in a goal because Turbo leaves the ball yet again. Oh dear, this is not the best play. Like this touch by Turbo, I have no idea what he's doing, but again, Scrub, he's taken himself out of the game a couple of times. He could have been behind Turbo right here if he just rotated back quicker, played a bit more safe, but instead he just drives right in front in a circle. Not the best play by Turbo and Scrub. Managing to turn a 3-1 lead into a 4-3 deficit in moments. In three very, very easy to defend attacks, it has to be said. But credit to X3 and Yemen, they stuck at it. They managed to get the pressure, and that's another shot on target. Turbo is equal to it this time because there was no speed to the ball. Yemen and Turbo, or Yemen and X3, massive favorites now, unless Turbo can do something crazy. Oh, that's probably gonna hit the ground. Oh, Scrub is there though. No way, Scrub out of nowhere. I didn't see him coming in from the autocam. Gets the equalizer on 0 seconds. X3 actually popping the ball the wrong way, and although Turbo's not there, Scrub is, to just dink it over the line. The green screen's kind of messing up. Hey, thanks for the heads up, dude. I'll try and fix that for you real quick. I'll just increase the similarity a little bit. There we go. And while I'm in the middle of doing that, Scrub and Turbo actually take the game. Off a good old Scrub killer kickoff. Yemen getting completely out of position by going for the boost. And although it kind of takes a bit of a ricochet on the way in, that's what you get for going for the corner boost and kickoff. Put yourself in an awful, awful position. And, you know, even if Scrub faked that ball, Yemen would have been out of the game. Not the best play to go for that corner boost on twos, in twos especially. And yeah, especially against somebody as dangerous as Scrub. But we will get the third iteration of these players, Yemen and Scrub this time, against Turbo and X3. So Turbo has won every single game since we invited him. He's 5-0. I think I'm going to make this the last game, by the way, guys. So I'll look for somebody to host immediately after this. We'll see if Turbo can keep his 100% win record going, or will Scrub be able to win his second game? All of X3. Oh, Turbo! Immediate answer to my question. He says, "Yep, I'm just gonna go ahead and win another game if that's okay with you guys." Yemen not clearing it very well, just hitting it straight into Turbo. That is a really close cheat by Scrub. It's a really close cheat. I wonder if Yemen told him to do that, because Yemen is one of the players who does like to call out what position he's going to shoot the or try and get the ball to go in into from the kickoff. Like he'll sometimes say back right, and he'll try and lose the kickoff deliberately to his right, or he'll say front left and try and win it to the left and so on, or just, you know, he'll try and kill it in the center. Like it's something that a lot of teams should try and do, just have a deliberate plan on the kickoff instead of just aimlessly hitting it and hoping for the best. Very ambitious here, but yeah, I mean, I don't know why he was going in for that ball. Scrub was on a rotation all the way back, so nobody was in the center, even if he did get the ball to go into the middle, which was not the most likely outcome regardless. So, safe to say I'm not a fan of that play. He's launching himself at the ball in the corner. Turbo equal to Scrub's attack, much like we saw in the earlier 1v1s, and Yemen with the slowest shot in the existence of Rocket League. But he does rotate around and keep the ball active in blue half. Not going to materialize into anything useful though. Oh, what a save by Yemen. Reading that shot by X3 very, very well. It was a good fast shot by X3. He took it very early, but Yemen was equal to it. And X3 has been doing some work these games. You know, he's putting shots in the net, and these touches from like the side of the pitch, like just coming off the wall and chipping it towards the net, they've been really, really good for X3. He's done that 3 or 4 times now, where he just, you know, whips the ball down off the wall into a shooting position. Really, really good play as Yemen just sends sends Turbo home, and Scrub just fix X3. Yemen's not able to get the shot on target though, so disappointing by him after Scrub's mind game was successful. The rebound by Yemen was not. And yeah, Turbo's just been pretty equal to just about every attack that Scrubs had this in all these games, and also getting another demo. So the mock EU, like what do I want to call it, like persona, is shining through. The trash talk is. The trash talk is reigning supreme once more. Does somebody remember who won with Turbo in the first game? Was it X3 and Turbo, or was it no, it would have been Yemen and Turbo. So Yemen's won a game, Scrubs won a game, and now X3's winning a game with Turbo. Turbo's won every game. We've had this a few times today where one player's gone 3-0, and all the other players just win one game, lose two each. Oh dear, that's just a horrendous set shot by Scrub. I don't know what he's doing this with these shots. And Yemen just leaves the ball in the midfield. This is not very good play by Scrub and Yemen. Scrub just whiffing the set shot completely. Doesn't even put a hit on the ball. Never mind a good hit on the target. It doesn't seem to be all there. I think Scrub and Yemen probably lacking in, you know, solid mentality right now. Yemen a bit lucky that X3 didn't move up for that weak clear. It's a reasonable touch, but again, Turbo is probably going to be able to take control of the ball. Probably. Pops it back to X3. I like that. Oh dear. Yemen with another straight whiff, and Turbo coming in to hit this one off the top of X3's car. Does kind of take himself out of the game for not much, but Yemen's shot is miles off target, and Scrub's going to have a really big job to do to make anything out of this one. Especially now. Oh no, actually he does get the better of X. No, he gets the better of Turbo, I'll say. X3 doing a great job though, just stalling that ball away from the goal. Exactly what he had to do, and now Scrub's backed off with a low boost. Turbo taking Yemen at the game fairly easily. Not the best shot selection there, though. When he went for that pop, the ball was always going to land pretty much in the goal line where Scrub was. So I feel like just throwing it or taking a shot would have been better there. X3 probably going to make it 3-0. Oh, barely squeaks it in. Wow. Barely squeaks it in. X3 back into game. Yeah, it seems like X3 is back in Rocket League. Seems like he's back. He was supposed to play the RLCS qualifier number 1 with Tardix and Martin the boss, but he didn't show up, and he just disappeared for a couple of weeks. I don't know why. Yeah, Turbo looking imperious right now. I mean, this is what happens when you play Rocket League more than your peers. You play better. And again, Turbo. Just a clinical finish. Yemen with a rotation that's just too wide and inefficient. Scrub with a bad clear. Yemen going up on the wall there. Played some of my best games earlier today, but these are some of my worst. Well, I mean, 3 games is a pretty small sample size. I don't think anybody's going to make a judgment on a player based on 3 games. So no worries, Yemen. I'm sure my viewers and my YouTube subscribers won't mind if you've not played up to your usual standard. Good recovery there, though, to get a goal back, maybe the glimmer of hope. He says freestyling. He's going for something fancy. Maybe giving up on the win, just going for a montage goal. It's because of the streams. Turbo saying that. Yeah, I'm getting nervous in front of all my viewers. What up, Hillian, by the way? How you doing? So yeah, you guys making Yemen nervous, and of course, Yemen is YMCA, for those of you who are wondering. Wasn't able to do it with Scrub. Turbo, again, punishing on some very, very poor defending. Scrub just not getting the better end of a 50-50, and Yemen is nowhere to be seen. It says casting the Scrub. No, it doesn't. Anyway. Pretty sure my title doesn't say that. Pretty sure my title says casting private 2v2s, scrub killer turbo with X3 Yemen. That's the names of the player in the lobby. Oh, beautiful play by Yemen, putting it into his own net. So Turbo with a good long shot, and Yemen, he's had enough of this game. Just wants to score in some goal, even if it's his own goal. And that's exactly what he does. Scrub whiffed the boost, since we failed the 50-50. Not really. He whiffed the boost and then he flipped past the ball, so there's a lot more to it than just whiffing the boost. He didn't flip through the ball either. He kind of did the thing where you want to hit the ball like on one side in particular, and he just flipped past the ball.